Hello, hi guys, good evening. It's Dr. Ashok here. It's my first video to show you how to do USG guided procedures. Firstly, I would like to tell you few my observations, though I am not a quite senior person to show you, but these are my personal observations which are really useful to me while doing the scan and doing USG guided procedures like fnac, biopsy, or we do pigtail catheterization. I'll tell you some basic things which see, come nearer. If this is a probe and this is a convex probe, okay, they say they have virtual convex and beam formation is like this. What we see on the screen is like this. If this is the probe and this is the area of area which we see in the screen, my personal observation is actually this is how we perceive it, but while putting the needle, if we put the needle considering this and we put the needle like this downward, so what we think it would appear on the screen, but in reality there is nothing like, means while doing procedure these things are not practical, means the actual area of we see on the screen is like this only, because the projection of the beam doesn't start from here, it starts from here. So what I want to tell you, this much area is the blind area. The actual projecting part lies between this portion. This much portion is blind area. Okay, another thing, so many a time what happens, we put the needle very close to probe, we try to project it from, if this is the edge of the probe, this is a vertical edge of probe, and we try to put it like this and we don't see it on the screen. The main reason is because it goes in your blind area. So remember this thing, while putting needle vertically or while directly putting needle from the side vertical where the lesion is quite below the probe, we put the needle here, it goes like this and comes out like this, but it is not seen on the screen. So we have to tilt needle or angle the needle by this way. So this or this means nearly keep the angle between 30 degree to the vertical axis, so that skin be the lesion or the needle would be seen after 2 to 3 centimeter. So it's always better to keep the lesion at this part of the screen, not nearer to probe. Means if you are putting it, then consider it, if it is seen like this on the screen, consider it is lying at this part, means consider the blind area of the screen. That is the my point to say. Second observation is, if we see probe on this direction, on transverse section, if this is a probe, so and it has two part, this one is receiving and this one is projecting part, the rays goes from this part and received on this part, so area which is facing to you or the in this part, if this is the pointer which we keep always to the patient or to the us, if this is a if we put it in normal this position, the area which we are nearer to us, means this area, is receiving area. So if we want to put the needle, put it in this area only. If we put it in this part, it won't be seen on the screen. So we have to put the needle like this. And what I was telling, if we are keeping it like this and if we put the needle, considering this would be the lesion and go, it won't come on the screen. You have to keep it like this, then and then only it will appear. And second part is, you have to keep it nearer to this part. Thirdly, go backward. We have logic P9 machine in my center. I used to practice. I practice it on the jelly in the bowl, and you also practice it in the same way. Try to hit the air bubbles in the jelly, and by the practice you will get an orientation. It hardly needs a half an hour, so you will get a good orientation how to put the needle. Thirdly, few basic things are which I considered in my residency and my practice. Never go blind. I'll tell you one incident. I was putting pigtail catheter and I was not seeing the needle. Still I was progressing it further, and when I saw it, it was just nearer to porta, so it could be a disaster. It and bahut bada lapda ho jayega. I'll show you on the slit. Put it like this. Come near. Te doni dakav. I'll show you on this first nearer part. If you put like this, it won't appear on the screen. Show the screen. Now show it here. Khali dakav. If you put it like this, see, I'm putting 2 to 3 cm and still it has not appeared on the screen. Show it to the this thing box. Now I further see 1 to 2 cm is gone and it is still not appeared on the screen. After see, now only tip has appeared on the screen and here 2 cm are gone. We have to progress further. It is nicely screen seen on the screen. If I go show it, if it is put in nearer to this part, if this part it is seen on the screen, show it. And if I progress it further to the this side, it is disappeared from the screen. Show it on the screen. Now I am going, keep it on the screen only. Now I am coming closer backward. See, this is seen and this is gone. It is still under the probe but not seen, and when it is come to the back side, it is seen on the screen. So this is the trick. Thirdly, you have to manipulate the day angle. Thirdly, once you are in the body, you cannot change the angle. Means if you see, if you are in this liver, and now you somehow know that this needle should be at this part, so you cannot directly go from this to like this. Fanning like this action would damage the tissue. You come out, go further. You come out and hit the target. Never try to manipulate in the tissue. It will it would damage the tissue. Understood? ऐसा नहीं करने का. Come out. So putting needle is important, and you should not manipulate it. These are the things. Thirdly, one more thing. Never do adventures in your center when you don't have any backup. Don't always try to avoid serious means major procedures, means which may involve complications like pneumothorax or rupture of few major vessels. Always keep the backup. Explain the patient up to the extent of death consent. Don't frighten him, but tell him that we don't have a backup. This thing can happen. If something goes wrong, nearer hospital is at this distance. And don't charge less. Charge it as much as you can, so it won't devaluate you. That's the thing. Thank you. Hello. One more thing which I forget to tell or share. How to keep an angle of the procedure or the needle. There are two types, means in the soft tissue like liver or any other soft tissue where lesion is in the muscular or soft tissue part, we have to first screen it, fix the probe, and fix the lesion, fix the overlying part in case of breast tissue, fix it properly with the pressure and keep it tight. Then keep the probe there and fix the picture what you want. Then don't move it. And then put the needle. One simple trick is keep this line in the mind. Try to align it to this this line. And considering if lesion is that side, you have to put it like this. Considering like this. So two things. Your needle should be to this part, not this nearer part, which part one which is receiving end. You should be in that part of the probe vertically, and alignment should be parallel to this line which is on the probe. So that is the angle of beam, the rays. So two things, and third angle. Angle you should calculate. You can calculate it on the screen also. There is a measurement, angle measurement, generic angle measurement, but you can do it by eyeballing also. So you need not to measure the exact angle. So keep it parallel to this line on this part, and consider the angle, put needle from this part. Getting this? Not nearer to this, parallel to this, and angle to this. This is one where you are in the soft tissue. In case of the pleural effusion, when you are aspirating fluid, or the pleural effusion, or this thing, ascites, or any big collection, at that you have luxury to move the needle. Then first screen it, get a picture in your mind that this thing, you have put the probe like this, see the good pocket, so tilt it to that side, tilt it to a nearer side, and you should fan it, and you will get an idea that this much part is safer. No soft tissue, no other vital structure is coming in the way of needle. So once you decide the area of entry from the skin, put the needle, and with the good position, means in case of pleural tapping, you have to go at the upper margin of lower rib. Likewise, don't go very close to the rib. It may damage the peri. It is painful basically. So at the upper margin of lower rib, and then you can locate the needle otherwise also. Means likewise, when you when we locate the femoral length, where the section of the FL, so like that you can target the needle, you can locate the needle. In case of the fluid where the big pouch is available, so put the needle as per the convenience of the patient or you. And in case of the lesion in soft tissue, first fix the probe, then don't move it, and then put the needle. Don't try to locate the needle. Don't move the probe. Once you are getting, in case of soft tissue lesion, where you fix the lesion, you fix the path in your mind, and then don't move this hand, don't move the probe. Just try to manipulate, and don't manipulate like this. You come out, come in. Means come out little. You some by the practice you get to know. Many of time what happens? The lesion is like this, and you put the needle like this. So this is a mismatch. So try to do it like this. In case of left lobe liver abscess, the probe is put like this, and you have to keep the needle aligned to this part. That is the basic thing. But it comes by practice only. Thank you.